is Don Draper?
Excuse me?
Who is Don Draper?
Now, that's the million-dollar question that kicks off season four of Mad Men. You know who he is? He's the genius ad man, the Madison Avenue man of mystery. Now, this is usually where Don stands. It's the position of power, calling the shots and impressing the clients. He's just as comfortable here in the boardroom as he is in the bedroom. With Don Draper leading the pack, Mad Men has won heaps of awards, including three consecutive Golden Globes and back-to-back Emmys for Most Outstanding Drama Series.
Who knows who you are?
They loved you.
Anything else?
Plus, you sound like a prick.
That's not nice.
But what is nice is getting a sneak peek of Mad Men Season 4, and Movie Extra has got the latest series of this phenomenal show hot from the US. Now, Don has gone from this to this.
Can I walk you in?
No. I know that trick.
I'm not happy. And I don't think it's funny or cute. Why is this empty?
Because you drank it all.
But make no mistake, Don is still hooking in the women. And they're hooking into him. At the end of season three, we had that sensational cliffhanger ending where Don made a mad scramble to form his own ad agency in less than a day. Life gets really tough in the new digs, proving there's no Shark Tank like a goldfish bowl.
Who gives a crap what I say anyway? My work speaks for me.
Turning creative success into business is your work. And you've failed.
So things aren't great for Don. He's fighting with the clients his new agency is supposed to land.
You need to decide what kind of company you want to be. Comfortable and dead, or risky and possibly rich.
All I know is we don't want that.
Get your things and get out of my office now.
The troops in the new ad camp are finding life very challenging too.
You know something? We are all here because of you. All we want to do is please you.
In a moment, you'll find out which of your favourite characters are back for season four. And boy, are there some shocks and shockers. But first, let's get a feel for the time and place this season is set. 1964, New York.
Art in advertising? Why would anyone do that after Warhol?
Now, big changes were happening all over the world. Martin Luther King got the Nobel Peace Prize, the Beatles had a screaming legion of fans, and when people listened to music, they were choosing Bob Dylan over Frank Sinatra.
What are you talking about?
Beer was replaced with marijuana.
I thought I saw someone with a beer. It's easier than finding a beer, if you like it.
Wood panels were replaced with abstract patterns.
Oh.
So you knew about this?
No. Yes. I feel like I'm getting sucked into that thing.
And fussy button-down 50s culture.
Shall we?
We're just waiting on Don.
Was being replaced by a loose, sexy 60s culture.
I have a boyfriend. He doesn't own your vagina.
So, big changes all round in Mad Men Season 4. Now, let's find out which of your favourite characters are back. And without giving anything away, just take a teeny look at what you can expect to see and enjoy on Movie Extra. It'll knock your bobby socks off, that's for sure. OK, let's start with my favourite character, Joan. Married life to the surgeon of her dreams isn't what she thought it would be.
We don't know that.
Oh, that makes me feel better. Just keep marking off the days on the calendar while keep planning for our future.
I'll see you tomorrow when you're on your way out.
But on the upside, she's back in the office doing what she does best, manage.
Interested?
I am.
Breast, thigh?
And walk around.
Excuse me.
You're off limits.
I don't think he's the one who needs to be reminded.
Oh, come on. He was all over you the time you wore that red dress, the one with the bow in the back that makes you look like a present.
You have an incredible memory.
Well, I think about it a lot. That dress, I mean. Could you wear it?
Now, Roger is still the wisecracking larrikin who still gets the lion's share of the best lines.
This girl's terrific. She looks like Virginia Mayo. She's 25. You hit it off, come Turkey Day, maybe you can stuff her.
So where's Don's wife, Betty? Well, she's still living in the family home.
Hello, Daddy.
Hello.
You're carrying a mortgage,
plus insurance and taxes for a house you don't live in.
We haven't found the right place for the kids.
Well, either do as we agreed, or I'm gonna need to collect rent.
What?
So if it's not Don, who is living there? Well, it's Betty's new man.
Stop it. Stop it.
Who the hell is he?
She's still a cow of a mother.
There's Marshmallow.
But at least she's got a guy who wants to give her a bit, more than Don did.
What are you doing?
Another of the greatest characters, because he tries so hard and shoots himself in the foot so often, is Pete Campbell.
Every time you jump to conclusions, Tom, you make me respect you less.
What?
Look, I'm done auditioning. Enjoy it. It's the last thing we're going to get from them.
What?
Did you kill Sugar Baron?
You son of a bitch.
And Freddie the Drunk is back too, working with Peggy. Her modern 60s outlook contrasts sharply with Freddie's very old-fashioned ideas.
On a short list, I got Tallulah, Jessica Tandy, Barbara Stanwyck, and Doris Day.
I don't even understand your list. What's wrong with Elizabeth Taylor?
Isn't it about making old ladies look good?
Nothing makes old ladies look good.
The Ponds does. That's the point. If young girls started using it, maybe they'd find a husband, they wouldn't be so angry.
All I was trying to say is that I've used the stuff, and I think there's something about the experience of putting it on, looking in the mirror.
If we were to go another way, that's not a bad idea.
Indulging yourself, right?
No. If you use Ponds, you'll get married.
That's not what I was saying.
Harry was the one-man TV department and still is.
Has someone been using my office?
Mr. Sterling doesn't have a television.
They told him we laugh about him.
I don't! Get him on the phone, get him in here, or camp out in his driveway.
He hung up on me. I think he was crying.
I wish we really had a second floor so I could jump off it.
But hey, it's not all doom and gloom on Madison Avenue. It's a new era with a new agency and a fresh start for the main man, Don Draper.
I think that's a little suggestive.
Good. That's what I was going for.
What do all the good boys and girls want for Christmas? Lucky strike!
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You'll think all your Christmases have come at once when Mad Men Season 4 kicks off at your place. So form an orderly conga line in front of the TV and tune in to Movie Extra 8:30 Thursday, September 2, when the first sensational episode hits Australian screens. Hot from the US, the latest season of the Emmy Award-winning Mad Men.
Come on, let's go!